This is Tai Chi Salon. Welcome to this interview with my friend, Kyoko Kashiwagi. Did I say that right?
Yeah.
Welcome, Yokoso. Thank you for coming. Domo arigatou gozaimashita. Very nice to have you. So, Kyoko is my classmate at William Chen School, and she is also a dancer and a choreographer and a competition gold medalist, which I'm proud of, so I'm going to say that.
Oh, thank you.
And so let's do it like this. So we had the set questions, right? So I'm going to ask you the set questions, and then at the end of the interview, or later on in the interview, I have something that I did with everybody. I did it with Alex. I did it with Richard, you know, Mullen, where it's called the definition. So I give you a definition and you give me a short answer to the definition.
Okay.
Just we'll do that and see what happens with that. So let me start with the first question. What's been keeping you busy these days?
Well, I'm busy. I'm very busy here because I'm in Japan. Yes. So since 2020 March, I'm here in Japan. So because of the pandemic, Actually I came here because of my work. So I and my husband are filmmakers, and our film was going to be shown in Japan. So from May, so that's why we came here. But the situation changed. So since that we stayed here, and briefly I went back to New York to actually pack our stuff, because we've been renting the studio, house room there, but we never be there. So I quickly went back, but immediately after I came back to Japan again, because this is so comfortable to be, and I can practice here so well. I want you to see the situation right in front of me, but it's ocean, completely.
Wow, that's so nice.
It's beautiful. So I practice every day by the sea, because which is right in front of our house.
Yeah. So, I saw the pictures of you with your cat on Facebook by the ocean, and I was wondering, this is not New York.
Exactly. So that's why I'm so busy, because cats visit me all the time when I practice, and people around here, so nice. So Merrow, because it's a small village. So it's such a tiny village and everybody know each other. So if I'm here, everybody come to greet me. And I talk with them, and cats talk to me. And also the sun is amazing. So I wake up with sun, because okay, here we go. And I wake up. And I practice in the morning time, 2-3 hours. I practice. I like to do more.
Awesome. But,
I have no time. So it's time keeps going. And because of the sun, I have to do the laundry. And I do laundry every day because sun is amazing. So the end of the day, everything is dried out. You know, the laundry is. So outside, I do everything outside. Like, the sun, wait. I do it. And I have to cook for me and my husband. He's always, hungry. He's working here. He's so happy to be here to work. So he's working here. So everything's like a non-stop. Like I keep working. And the end of the day, sun is leaving. You're there already. So goodbye. And I start to sleep because I feel so sleepy at night. And I sleep and wake up early, practice, work. So I thought I can be relaxed, and actually I'm relaxed, but I have more time here, but busier than being in New York, I realized.
So have you had an opportunity to teach any Tai Chi or forms to anybody there, or online or in person? Or?
Yes, I still teach online for CUNY students.
Oh, wow, how's that going?
It's amazing. They are very patient because, you know, they've been learning online since March last year. So I left CUNY. I mean, I left New York because CUNY was closed. I teach at CUNY, so CUNY was closed physically, and they shifted to online class. So that's why I could do it in Japan, from Japan. So I left them, my students there, and I came here, and I felt so worried about them because they started feeling, oh, I feel a little bit fever, or professor, I feel maybe like, I was always saying them like, no worries. If you practice Tai Chi, you're fine. So that's, I was telling them, but it wasn't true. You know, many students got, you know, infected, and their families, members, and passed, and everything was so.
Sad. This is.
Yes, but I thought my function here is like keep practicing with them. So it was hard because there is time difference. So it's 14 hours. I have to wake up and teach at 12 midnight and teach until 4 in the morning. But I was doing it. It was hard for me, but it's nothing for comparing to them. You know, they are really, you know, hanging there in New York, and you know, inside of the room and situation I heard was really, really difficult. So to me, it's nothing to do, you know, here, like wake up 12, no worries, no, nothing. So I've been teaching online for CUNY, and I'm still doing it. So it's almost 1 year. And in the fall 2021, this year, I'm gonna do it because department chair asked me to do it in Boom. I'm still in Japan. They are so nice to me. Like, oh yeah, we need you. So can you teach our students? And I'm so, you know, honored to still I can do it from this distance.
Yeah. That's so awesome. Awesome. So talk a little bit about the method, because I'm up, you know, I was talking with Richie Mullen about that. And you know, Alex, he teaches you know, he does classes on Facebook, and I've, you know, as a teacher, I've had to adopt my methods, you know, for the Zoom format or for the online format. I'd be interested to see how you navigate the classes. For example, what I do is I have a camera in the front, which is a 120 camera, or 120 lens. And then I have my iPhone in the back. So they have a front view of me and a back view of me. It's not really so technically, but I had to develop this method. And then, you know, obviously, I miss not being able to, you know, to adjust the students and feel, you know, feel what they're feeling. And you know, sometimes the students don't say something, but I know that something is not right. And it's a challenge for me, and I'm sure it must be a challenge for you to bridge that gap, you know, by virtually. How many students do you have?
24 to 26.
Wow.
Yes. And I had two classes, but recently I have one class right now in this semester. It's challenging, as you said. There is so much gap between the physical class and this. But still, there is an possibility, but I'm not a technical person. Even we make film, but I'm so old school. How can I say? I do with this my computer, this laptop, and I don't use anything else. And I try to, you know, go.
Right. So do you face from the back like Master Chen? Do you do like, or try to do two different views? Because I find what I do is I go, okay, here's my right hand, here's my left hand. I'm going to do it from the front. Now I'm going to do it from the back. And I show the postures. And then sometimes what I'll do is I'll record the class, and then I'll send them the recording of the class afterwards so they can use it as a study.
Nice. Yeah. I do the same way. I start with frontal And yeah, difficulty, as you know, is like if I raise my right hand, I have to say left hand. But to me, it's very easy because I'm a dancer and I do both.
Ah, yes.
Even with Master Chen, after I came home, I was practicing other side from very beginning because I'm a dancer. If I do only one side, I feel so strange. So when I'm home, I always do opposite side.
So you practice the form to the right side and the left side.
Yes.
I just figured that out. I've been able to do it for a couple of years now, and I actually developed a little form that goes to both sides, the same form. You know, so yeah. And I experimented with my students doing the mirror image, but they got confused. So I just go from the front and then I turn around and I go from the back and I just do it like that.
Yeah, exactly. Some students always ask me to go, you know, do the backside.
Yeah.
Everybody's different. And some say, oh, from the side, this way, that way. We have a lot of interactions. Normally, students cannot talk because they have to mute their voice mic. But I like to keep talking with them. So, you know, student ask me, request me like, Professor, can you go this side? Okay, sure. And I go and watch it. And
that's make great.
Sure if they are fine. And yeah. I always go with them. So, but mostly start with frontal and I show back and everybody practice with me from my back and side. So I show everything and just the feet. Or just the fingers. So it really depends on what we are working on that time. And I go slow. I always make sure if they are comfortable to do it. And I don't want them to just, you know, pretend they're understanding. And of course, to understand Tai Chi, the detail essence is not easy, but still everyone can get something. So every class we go over. So today, let's do this, let's do that. And it's so different from physical class. Physical class is more like I touch them and I make sure. And we have sort of curriculums. The end of the semester, we go from here to here and we do that and mostly accomplished.
Yeah.
But this one, no, we have no plan, zero plan. I write the syllabus and we go over, but forget it, and we go little by little, and so that works better online.
So you just kind of go on the intuition, you know, of what you feel. Yeah, I think that you can. I'm getting to the point now after doing this online for almost over a year now. Mm-hmm. I'm starting to feel that I can feel what the student is feeling, but it took me a long time. It took me a few months. Where I was in the beginning when they said, okay, there's the pandemic, the college is closed, you have to teach a class online. I was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? I had to sweat, you know, I figured it out.
Wow.
And I tell you what I really miss is going to classes with Master Chen, going to the school.
Tearing. I know.
Maybe you can talk a little bit about your experiences as a student of Master Chen.
Yes, I'm so lucky I have met him in my life, you know. Without him, I not exist here. I passed already. I don't know. It was difficult for me to live. That time when I met Master Chen, I was always, I mean, optimistic since I was a kid. But the time when I met Master Chen, I was completely bottom of the everything, like bottom of the sea bottom, how can I say? But I was lucky someone recommended me to go to Master Chen, like, hey, my master is amazing, blah, blah, blah. Like, oh, really? At that time, I was taking I and my husband shooting mentally ill patient in Japan. It's like a 2 years project we've been shooting, and I totally got the feeling of them. And I was like, "Oh, life is life is difficult, you know, that I never felt in my life before.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that time I go, how can I live? How can I solve this difficulty in life? Then I met Master Chan, and actually my husband took a documentary of Tom Odernes, you know.
Oh, okay. The sculptor.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, long lifetime student of Master Chan.
Exactly. So my husband directed the Chinese TV documentary on him. So he followed Tom by his camera, and Tom went to Master Chen's class.
Oh, wow.
And I saw that program every time when my husband make a, you know, program. So I see it and I go, oh, this is good, this is bad. And that one was like, oh, Tom Odernes is, wow, very interesting. And teacher, Taichi teacher is amazing. Immediately, you know, after I saw him, like I fell in love, like, wow, beautiful guy, like a person, beautiful, like a creature, you know, such a beautiful creature. It's like a, maybe 5 seconds or something, like just a boom, Master Chen. That's it. But I was like, wow, one day I like to see this guy. Then, you know, when I was like, oh, that is difficult. That was like much later. My friend said, oh, my master, I take my master. That was Master Chen. And I was like, this guy is the guy who I wanted to see. And it was such a coincidence, but it's not coincidence. So I immediately started with Master Chen. And Master Chen, I never ask any question. I am super Japanese. How to say? Like, I don't ask question. I just see and I learn by my eyes. And I hesitate to ask question because I'm too silly to ask question. Always, that's what I feel. Then I never say, ask anything to Master Chen. But from the beginning, Master Chen said, I have an answer for you. He came to me, he gave me amazing words. Every time when I went to Master Chen, I was crying, like, yes, that's right, that's right. Like, I was like, completely, like, my problem at the time, I don't know, I didn't know what was the problem. I was just feeling so hard. But every time when I see Master Chen and practice with him, I was like, oh, yes, yes. This is good. Yeah, I'm fine. I'm fine. Then I was completely well enough. So, but I was there every day to see Master Chen, just Master Chen's hand, Master Chen's back, Master Chen's hearing his voice. That so helped me and inspiring. How beautiful he is. Like, how human being can be this beautiful. Like, he was like, anything he does, it was, wow, so beautiful. Wow. And anything he said, the voice itself, it comes to me like, melting to my body, like amazing, like soft, become so soft. Everything was like just like, oh, so beautiful. And I couldn't stop going to his school to see him, just to see him. But I never asked any question, just seeing him and moving with him. So without that experience, I don't exist like this here. I'm sure.
I think it's kind of interesting. And you know, I was thinking about you in the classes, and you know, I don't necessarily want to make this comparison, but it just kind of reminded me of like, well, for example, Chen Manqing had the 6 core students, and one of the students was Maggie Newman. Maggie Newman was a dancer, but she was also, and it kind of reminds me of you. I'm not necessarily comparing you to Maggie Newman, but you're kind of like our Maggie Newman in a way, because you're a dancer, but you're also not afraid to mix it up with the boys and the push hands, and you sort of can hold your own, and you went out there and got yourself a couple of medals and stuff, and I think that's really cool. You're embracing all the aspects of the art that Grandmaster Chen teaches us, which is also the martial, not only for the health, not only for the movement, So let me ask you this. Can you talk about how Tai Chi has influenced your approach to dancing and to choreography? How has Tai Chi influenced that?
Well, because Master Jin's teaching, Tai Chi, influenced me enormous, like it changed my life. Everything changed because I'm a different person, you know? So, and I keep changing, of course, because I live. But so far, everything has changed. How to move, for example, it's completely different. I used to be a dancer. I mean, I'm still, but recently I see myself, I'm a Tai Chi practitioner. I still dance, but especially here, I'm in Japan, and these days, past a couple of days, I didn't make my own dance project. I didn't do that. I was so busy to teach Tai Chi. I was so lucky that I got so many great students. Every day, like 7 days a week, I was teaching Tai Chi. Since Master Jin told me that I can teach, then I keep teaching for them, for myself. Always I hear Master Jin that anything he say is always right to me. And he said, you teach, and this is right. I did, that was the right thing. So I'm a dancer, but I'm a Tai Chi practitioner. And so when I dance, it's different, but to me, dance is more like expression. Express yourself, express something through my body. And Tai Chi is not. Tai Chi is more like a happening. It's like a phenomenon. You have to make it happen. So it's completely different to me. So when I dance before I met Master Chen, I was kind of struggle with my ego, how I look like, how I can express this. This is my message. I don't really have message, but this is what I want to say. And they get this, they get that. Or is this a correct degree? Or how do I show this? But now I don't think about it. So, but still it's express. Dance is expression. And when I do Tai Chi, it's like I have to let I shouldn't have any ego. Ego to me is like an attachment, But Tai Chi, you can't have that. If you have that, it doesn't happen. You know, it's like to me, it's like so difficult. Tai Chi is so difficult to me because I have to empty myself, as always Master Jin said, which is not easy. You know, little me, my tendency, my history, everything comes up, show up. And I react to something, but let go and empty and just let it happen. Let nature happen in me. Yes? My neighbor came. That's what happened here. Always neighbor. Konnichiwa. Sumimasen. Hold on.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you. Sumimasen. My neighbor brought eggs, which just came out from chicken.
From the chicken, oh, cool. That's great.
That's great, that's our everyday life. People come and bring a fish and it came from ocean right now. They're like still alive. You have to do sashimi. No, I can do it, please do it. And come on, and they cut the fish.
Can you send some to me?
Yeah?
Can you send some to me, please, sashimi?
But thank you. Oh my God, this is a beautiful thing. But
anyway, yeah. Awesome. So this is very interesting what you were talking about being empty, about, you know, that to me sounds like, you know, you connect yourself to your feelings, or you shut off your ego, you shut off your mind, and move with your feelings. That's what Master Chen says all the time when he's, well, I'm in the class, and in fact, the other day I was doing, you know, like the fan, and he goes, Lincoln, this is not, your heart is not big enough. He said to me, your heart is not big enough. Mm. You know, you have to open up your heart. You have to, you know, you have to, I'm going to give you a hug. I love you. That kind of, you know, selfless action that makes you complete the postures and reach out. So I guess, yeah, I mean, that it's very interesting to ask someone. It almost sounds like you've switched your careers from studying with Master Chen.
Yes. But Master Chen is a great dancer. I mean, he doesn't express himself, but nature express through his body. You know, I see nature through his body. That makes me feel cry, like, because it's beautiful. It's happening again. It's like I see completely like a laws of nature through his movement. And I got the literacies. When I started, I didn't know why I was so moved. I moved from his movement, from looking at through, you know, his existence. I didn't know why I'm so moved, but little by little I got the literacy. Then I could see what's happening in his body. Like one day I was completely surprised. Like, it came, as you say, big heart came to me or to everybody in the class. Like a boom, like, well, I could see it like from him completely, or this way, that way. Like completely, it's like sometimes I see dragon in his body, but he doesn't do it, but it just happened in him. Like, wow, that's beautiful. And it's not really a dragon. This is an example, like the movement, or, you know, the wave or flow, and like so beautiful. And Master Chen is just being empty and it's happening there.
So yeah, Master Chen is kind of like an old dragon.
Yeah. It's amazing. Yeah. He said, I'm just a lazy guy, but it's not true. Yeah, it's not true. He's I'm sorry, I keep talking about him and that.
He's such a great teacher, and look what he's done for all of us. So maybe you could talk a little bit about this. You're talking about the form. Maybe you can talk a little bit about some of the other forms that you've studied, the sword form, the fan form.
Sure. As I studied 60 forms, Master Chen's form, and also sword, and fan form from Lewis.
From Lewis Malera, right.
And Chen Manchin's form, 37, from Master Chen. And long form, yes. I like everything. And depending on what time, what lengths I can practice, then sometimes I do 60, but mostly, in the morning time, I do long form. That makes me, you know, that wakes me up. And sword form, I like it, of course. Master Chen, but my level of my sword is as well as my form, maybe. My form, Master Chen always encouraged me, your form is good. But this is growing. So every day here in front of C, I still feel like, this is so new. Like Master Chen, he's 80 something, but I learned this today. I found this. Like, I'm like, wow, he's still finding something. Same here. Like my level is Master Chen. I'm here, but still finding so many things. Sword, I have to practice more. I got the gold, as you said, gold medal, but I have to practice more. But I still feel same way as the form I when I practice the form dropping and comes back to sword. So I got it one day, Master Chen's sword form. I was doing it and it came like, oh, it came. So sword started moving by itself, like my body. Wow. And Master Chen came, come. He said, come. Okay, good. Come. So he sees it. It came. Wow. And immediately he came. Come. Yes. Don't rush. So he knows like how I was like excited. Oh wow, you know. So that's my sword, and it's growing. So it's nice to practice. Only difficulty to practice sword is here. People are so afraid of me if I practice with sword. So I can't really practice every day, like once for a while. Okay, everybody, I'm not dangerous. And I do it quickly. Otherwise, they're like, oh. Even they knew me, they are so worried about this because I use a metal sword.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So that's sword fun. Luis was our, you know, big Tai Chi brother. And
he was great, such a sweet man.
And I learned a lot, and he kept encouraging me, like a fun form. He said, I practice form very seriously too. And I had some private with him, and he said, Kyoko, I like your fun form, like keep going. So I practice a lot, and I got the gold medal, as you said. But it can be better and better because it's alive. The form is alive. So my fun is really growing too. Every time when I practice fun, I remember Luis. And that the last day when I saw him was, you know, right after practice form together, fun together. He said, like, oh, one day, we lose Master Chen. That's he said, because Master Chen is older than us. One day he left us, but still we hear his voice like, oh, not quite.
Not quite.
And he said, I like your fun, Kyoko, enjoy. That was a last talk. So I really remember him every time when I practice fun. So I really appreciate before when I start, and when I finish, I always appreciate him. And one day I have to give this form to someone else, like me, was taught Luis. So far no one asked me to, you know, to give my form, fun form, to receive my form. I really deserve, how can I say, asked Luis to teach me seriously, and he did. So one day I have to give it to someone. I really feel it from Luis, and Luis got it from Master Rose in Taiwan, who I met when I visited Taiwan. I went to Rose and I said, Luis passed last year. But I got form, that was from you, him, and I got it. I'm practicing. And she said, that's good. But we didn't have time to really work on the fun. We briefly talk. Mm. So I like to give this to someone serious.
Awesome. So awesome that you do that. So what do you think are, If I was going to ask a general question, if I was going to say, what do you think are the most important things you've learned? You've pretty much answered these questions, but I'm just going to ask it to you as a formal question. What do you think are the most important things you've learned from the study of Tai Chi?
From Tai Chi.
What's the most important life lesson?
Being soft.
What does it mean being soft?
Being soft means if the when I live, when we live, something happened all the time. Always something happening. When I something happened, I become soft, soft. Come harder, softer, harder, softer. You know, I learn how to make myself softer through Tai Chi. So now I don't. I don't really react this way. More like a come and take it because I'm softer than this. So which makes my life so much easier. So I really appreciate this idea, concept, and also physically I feel it. I practice outside every day. Wind comes because it's ocean. Wind comes. More comes, I get more soft, softer. Then, wow, I feel so good. I never resist. Like, oh, cold. No, like, come. Oh, I take it. I feel so good. So most of the time, I feel good because of that idea and also my practice, like being soft. And sorry, I talk a lot, but last year was difficult because of this pandemic. It was so difficult, right? And I asked Master Jam, how I can survive when I get some difficult situation, which is right now. And Master Jam, the answer was, more comes, yeah, be softer. Yeah, and that's exactly what I was doing. And he said that, and yes. And think about the most difficult time, and is this harder than that time? Like, oh, that was difficult, but I'm fine now. Like, so the lesson to me is always from Master Chen, but from practice that I got from Master Chen helps me all the time, and getting my life is getting more and more like richer and easier because I think I learn how to make me soft.
Yeah, that's a great answer. Thank you for that answer.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to try this with you like I did for the other people that I've interviewed. I'm going to do the word definition, and you can give me your reaction or your answer. So I'm going to give you I'm going to start with this one. Energy. What is energy?
Energy? What's energy?
What is energy?
This. Energy. Energy is everything. Energy. Energy is living a lot, living life.
Okay, how about this one? Body awareness.
Body awareness. Enlightenment.
Wow, cool. How about this one? Breath.
State of mind.
Okay. How about this one? Ego.
Ego?
Ego.
I
know, we already talked about that one, but I'm going to give it to you again.
Ego, yeah, attachment.
Yeah. Attachment. How about this? I'm gonna give you. This is two words: fear and death.
Fear
and death.
Nature, fear and death, right? Fear and death, part of us, part of life, part of nature. Fear. fear. Fear is a reaction, right? Fear is a reaction. Which we hate normally, but it comes, but we don't have to keep it, right? Yeah, and death is natural thing. So it's like a life. Yeah, life. Well, one of the life aspect, I can say.
Oh yeah. Awesome. Awesome answer. Okay, so let me give you one more, and this is a group of words. Toes and fingers, push, pull.
Toes and finger?
Toes and fingers, push, pull.
Push, pull. It sounds like a massage. It sounds like, yeah. Toes and finger is like a lovers. Each other all the time. They react to each other all the time. Yeah, switch and light, you can say. Yeah, that's everything. That's Tai Chi. We only have toe and fingers.
Right, no body.
No body, right. And push and pull. Push and pull in yang. Everything is in yang, by the way. But push and pull in yang, one thing, hold. Push, pull. Yeah, at the time. That's happening. That's what happens. It's invisible, but that's everything, all the time.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask for one more definition from you, and this is something I asked with Alex and Master Chen, ongoing conversation. Qi, what is Qi?
Qi?
Yeah.
Qi, this. Big heart. Big heart, that's Qi, right?
Right.
Qi, I was kind of surprised that when I studied with Master Chen, he never talks about Qi. And many people talk about Qi, like, oh, let Qi do this, Qi do that. But Master Chen never talked when we started. Sometimes now he talks, but if we think about it, it's gone. No, because more. When I feel chi, I feel it all the time, of course, everybody, but more relaxed, chi gets bigger, like chi expand. So if we think too much, chi stuck, that's what I feel like. More like, forget about it. And chi grows. So it's like, yin yang, like too much here, like a chi is shrunk, kind of. More space, you know, empty, then qi expand. Qi has a space inside our body and it expand. And I think I feel so good with Master Chen because his qi comes consistently. That's why I always practice right, you know, close to him in the studio. Like, now I hear this is my spot because I feel so good from Master Chen. So qi is like this thing. Wow, it's expanding from, I don't know, his heart, our heart. I don't know, tan tian, I don't know, but from us or from everybody. So we react to each other because it's already there here.
The thing about qi that I realize, especially now with the remote learning, and here I am talking to you on Zoom, but somehow I feel your qi, somehow I feel your feelings, even though I'm just looking at at Kyoko as a picture. I'm not with you in the class. So qi is not something that I have to be in the room with to feel. So it's something more than just physical. Right. Even though, you know, the explanation sometimes, and Master Chen says it too, he says qi is mobility energy. He says qi is mobility energy that is generated by the action. And that's one of his definitions in my understanding, but it's kind of an ongoing conversation that I have with Master Chan, and also with, you know, the senior students, you know, you and Alex and people, always talking about what that means. I guess it's just a word.
Wow. Yeah, maybe I have to say, she is this, like that.
No. I think your explanation was fantastic. Do you have any words of advice or encouragement for someone who is just starting to learn Tai Chi? What do you say to the new practitioner, to the new student?
Enjoy. I always say enjoy. That's it. Yeah. I mean, yeah, if someone starts Tai Chi, enjoy. Yeah.
Wow.
If you enjoy, you learn yourself, you know. Yeah, you can't stop learning. You keep practicing because you're enjoying. So most important thing for me to teach, when I teach students, I say enjoy first. That's the first thing.
It sounds like you probably are very inspirational, a very inspirational teacher.
Oh, I hope so.
We hope so. We always hope so. So the video that you did by the water, the water mill, the video, mm-hmm. the where was that taken? Where did you take that video?
Here.
Oh, that was awesome. So that's your instructional video?
Actually, that was temple in front of that.
Yeah.
That was a temple. That was, I don't know why I took that. That time, yes, I was making an instructional video.
Uh-huh.
I thought that was good, but it was too far away. I like that situation. That's why I put camera on totally far away. But the scenery is beautiful, but for instructional, it's too far away.
Yeah, perhaps, but it looked very cool.
Oh, thank you.
You know, with the little title on the bottom. Is that something, did you finish that project?
I think so. I asked my husband to finish it, and I think.
Oh, okay. Did. Okay. Well, I look forward to seeing that if it's something that you finish.
Oh, thank you. I think that was a long time ago.
I think Tiffany put it up when Tiffany was, you know, she put it up on Facebook, and I saw it. That's when I saw it. You doing like the opening postures in front of the temple with the water and the light. It looked like a movie. It looked so cool.
Oh, yeah. Scenery, it's so beautiful. But my Tai Chi technique was as it was that time.
I know. For me, it's also, I do the instructional video, and I look at myself and I go, ugh. I just, this is me. It feels so much better than it looks. You know, it feels so much better than it looks, but I just keep it. This is a lifetime. It's a lifetime process.
Right, exactly.
It's a lifetime process. We'll be doing this for a lifetime.
Exactly. Till we die, or even after we die, we'll do this.
Probably.
Thank you, Lincoln.
Thank you very, very much. And thank you for talking to me from your beautiful home in Japan.
Oh, yes. Visit me.
So cool. And probably we'll do this again because I'm just starting to get the flow of this. I'm starting to get the technique of being a moderator, a talk show host. I don't know what I am. You're something. So I'm trying to be, I'm starting to get a vibe now. And it's really great for me too because everybody is different. Everybody has a different spirit. When I talk to Alex, we talk and we go into the cosmos. And I was talking to Richard Mullen, he was very, very gracious and had a lot of good insights. And you also have a very interesting point of view that's special and unique. I'm really glad I got you. So cool. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We're going to do this again, okay?
Sure.
All right. So this is Tai Chi Salon, and this is Lincoln Goins signing off. See you all soon. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye.